With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello everyone. A particle moving with kinetic energy E1 has de Broglie wavelength lambda 1. Another particle of same mass having kinetic energy E2 has de Broglie wavelength lambda 2. Lambda 2 is 3 times of lambda 1. Then you have to find out E2 minus E1. If I write down the de Broglie wavelength, it is equals to H by momentum, right? Where H is the Planck constant and P is the momentum. And P is the momentum of the body. So, if you see, we can write down this momentum is equals to H by lambda. So, as we got this momentum, right, we can write down the kinetic energy. We know that the kinetic energy is equals to momentum square by 2 times of mass. So, you can just put the value of momentum, it is H by pi. So, I will write H square by pi square into 2m is the kinetic energy, right? It is H square 2m this lambda square, right? So if you see, it is inversely related with lambda square, this kinetic energy, right? So I will write E2 by E1, it will be inversely related with the lambda square, right? So I will write lambda 1 by lambda 2 whole square. So, we know that this lambda 1 is equals to 3 times of lambda 2. So, if I put the value, it will be equals to 3 square. So, I will write E2 is equals to 9 E1. Now, we wanted E2 minus E1. E2 minus E1 will be 9 E1 minus E1. So, it will be 8 E1 will be the correct answer of this question. Now you can check for the option. So C here will be the correct option. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download DoubtNet app today.